Max, it's wonderful to have you here for us tonight for this celebration. How does it feel to be a part of it?
Oh, I'm flattered to be a part of it, to be amongst these wonderful people, and I'm thrilled.
We're also very excited about Bitter Harvest, which is about to have its premiere. Can you tell us, I guess, first of all, for people who aren't familiar with the project, just a little bit about what that one is all about?
Well, it's about a rather dark chapter in Ukrainian-Russian history. Essentially, not meaning to mince words, there was a genocide there that very few people know about under Stalin. And it's looking into it and hopefully bringing it to the attention of the majority of people who don't know about it. I play Yuri, who's a young man who... in order to live, fled his home and sought refuge in the cities in hope of a better life, as so many often do. Didn't go to plan. He ends up getting locked up in a gulag for assaulting a Soviet officer. He then escapes, returns to his village, and goes about setting right the wrongs that he sees. For me, it was more of a cerebral thing. It was something that, like most people, I knew so little about. And the response that I've seen to the announcement of the film and the trailers has been one of thanks. You know, it's a lot of Ukrainian citizens and also people who have left the country saying, thank you so much for bringing this story to the light. So that's what it was for me. It was just researching this period in history. I knew a little about the Cold War, but in relation to Ukraine, very little, because Stalin kept it all under wraps. The New York Times famously tried to run an expose, but the journalist was bribed by Stalin's people and made a full retraction. So it was really hidden from the world. I'd be reluctant to draw any comparison between what took place in the 30s, 40s and 50s to what's happening now. Different people, geographically are similar regions, but no. I'm proud to be telling that story and bringing that to light. If it has any vibrations with what's happening now, that's for other people to conclude, I'd say.
Of course, you've got a wonderful cast alongside you, Samantha and Terrence Stamp. Can you talk a little bit about your experiences working with the rest of the team?
Oh, well, Samantha Barks is fantastic. Terrence Stamp is a legend among men. You know, Superman and all that. It was wonderful. And I think it's going to be something special.
Beyond Bitter Harvest, what else should we be looking forward to from you in 2017? What else is on the horizon?
I'm doing a TV show called Condor, which is a remake of 3 Days of the Condor with Robert Redford. Bringing it up to date, of course, it's no longer the Cold War. It's now the CIA and the specter of radical Islamic terrorism. So it's exciting.
Who else are you working with on that one?
So far, it's just me on that one. But I'm waiting very eagerly to find out who else is cast.
And my final question is obviously the BAFTAs on Sunday. Who have you got your fingers crossed for, any specific films or performances?
I mean, La La Land, obviously. I am Daniel Blake, frankly, because it was the most stunningly moving thing I've seen all year. And almost everyone in it deserves an award, as far as I'm concerned. Yeah.